More than 1 million Americans have heart attacks each year and is the number one cause of death for both men and women. Dr. Terrence Baruch of Methodist Hospital in Arcadia, California, talks about the symptoms and treatments for a heart attack.
A heart attack is damage to the heart caused by reduced blood flow to the heart muscle through the coronary arteries. The most common symptoms of a heart attack for a man usually include a severe onset of chest pain in the chest, difficulty breathing, sweating, irregularity of the heartbeat. It's a variety of different symptoms that could be different in different people as well, men and women. But the major one is a sudden onset of new symptoms that are severe that they hadn't felt before. Women may have the same symptoms, but it could be different. Some women present with nausea. I had one patient that had jaw pain, went to her dentist, couldn't find anything wrong. Her internist finally sent her for a treadmill, shows she had a tightly blocked artery to the bottom of her heart. Women can have nausea, they can have difficulty breathing. A lot of different ways women can present that are different than men.
Dr. Baruch explains the test used to diagnose heart attacks.
To diagnose someone with a heart attack, usually the first thing we do is an EKG. And if the blood flow to the heart is cut off, the EKG responds in a certain way. If there's no blood flow to the heart, which is a major heart attack, we see changes in the complexes that look like tombstones. The segment, which is called the ST segment, elevates, and they look like tombstones in different leads. The EKG, if it shows those classic changes, then we know it's there for sure, and we can proceed to do an angiogram and then possibly an angioplasty, which is putting a small balloon to where the blockage is, unclogging the artery and restoring the blood flow. If it's not there, they do other tests. One is a blood test called troponins, which tells us if there is damage to the heart. It's very specific. That test takes about an hour to get back. So if the patient is stable, not having symptoms, then we're able to do that. Another thing we could do is what's called an echocardiogram, which is an ultrasound test of the heart. And that tells us if any of the walls of the heart are not moving as they should. If the whole heart is moving well except for one segment, that could tell us that there is a blocked artery to that segment that could be causing damage and could be a source of further damage as well. If someone is having an acute heart attack, it's called a STEMI, ST elevation MI, the artery is totally closed. The best treatment is to do emergency angioplasty, where we take people to the cardiac catheterization lab, do the angiogram, see if it's totally blocked, insert a small balloon to where the blockage is, inflate the balloon, and that restores the blood flow. That's the best treatment. That's the treatment that is shown to reduce mortality, meaning saving people's lives. You know, there's a choice, three different choices in treating clogged arteries. If you're stable, they can treat you with medications, cholesterol medicines, blood thinners, blood pressure medications, things like that. If there's a discrete blockage, maybe one that's discrete or two, we usually go with a balloon angioplasty and placement of a stent to keep the artery open. If the blockages are diffuse through all three coronary arteries, then you know, stents may not be good for that, and that's when you would have open heart surgery. I think we've been very successful. In the last 40 years, there's been a reduction in mortality of up to 30% in people with heart attacks and coronary artery disease. There are certain risk factors. Some are modifiable, some are not. Non-modifiable risk factors are your family history, your sex, males, more, your age. As people get older, they have more heart attacks. The things that you can modify are elevated blood pressure, which is a significant risk factor, elevated cholesterol levels in your blood, use of tobacco is something that can be modified, you know, losing weight, getting more exercise, a sedentary lifestyle is another risk factor. All of these things can be modified, and it does reduce your risk of going on to a heart attack significantly, and it's been well shown that that's the case. In the last 30 years, we have a lot of different things that can allow you to live longer and avoid a heart attack. And if you're having a heart attack, we have better treatments that we can do in an emergent situation that will save someone's life.